So let's start with the designing of a sampling plan. And what does the designing means? The designing means that we want to figure out the value of parameter n and the value of parameter c, which is the acceptance number. And given the value of alpha risk and the given the value of beta risk. So the first method is using the Poisson distribution, which is the very basic method. So here the consumer risk and producer risk may be given, or there may be some floating values, and there will be given some proportion of non-conformance, that is the value p, and the probability of acceptance. So we may be given the quality of the lot, and we may be given the probability of acceptance or probability of rejectance, or the value of alpha or value of beta. So probability to reject some lot will be at high level of quality will be very low, that would be around 5% 10%, that is the risk. And complementary, the probability to accept a good quality lot will be 90% 95%. So we may be said to determine some sampling plan that accepts a lot that are 6% non-conforming. That means the p value is 6%, which is 0.06, and 10% of time. So 10% of time means we want to accept the lot 10% of time. So this 6% is a bad quality lot. We need to remember that 1% is a good quality, around 1%, less than 1%, and around 5 to 7%, 10% is a bad quality lot. So we want to accept this lot with a probability of 10%. And also there are some sample values of C that could be given, that is 1, 2, 4, etc. So what is the possible view is, we are given some guess values of C, 0, 1, 2. We are given a value of P, a value of PA. So what we do is, we guess the value of C, and with given PA, we find the lambda value, that is NP. So what we do is, we are given the probability distribution chart of the Poisson distribution. So we use this C as the X number. So probability of X less than C. So we go to the chart where the mean are given, NP values are given. So the mean values are given over here, 0.1, 0.2, 0.3, and so on. And here C values are given, so 0, 1, 2, 3. So we go to the required values of C, we find the NP value. So this is the lambda value, which is the closest to the probability of acceptance. So this values are the probability values. So we find out the closest probability value, or if we need to interpolate between 0.8 and 0.9, we want a 0.85 value, we interpolate and we get 0.35. So this 0.35 is the NP value. And here the proportion value is given, P. So we can figure out the value of N. And hence, this N and this C will make the acceptance plan. So this we have figured out the value of N and C. Similarly, we could be given the probability of other side. That is probability to accept. And we may be given the probability to reject. Both could be given, and we can similarly use this chart to figure out the value of N and the value of C. And one of the generally the C values, guess C values of 0, 1 and 2 or 3, 4 are given, and we need to figure out the complementary N values. And here if NP is a decimal value, so the N value can come out to be 35.4. So here in any case, we would jump to the next number and take N as 36. It could be 35.1 also, or it could be 35.9. In all the conditions, we would jump to the next integer and take 36 as our answer for N. And then we may be asked to figure out that given this N and C values, so first we figured out the thing with respect to the consumer or with respect to the producer, anyone. And then we figure out the values of N and C, and then we want to evaluate that this plan is how given how much probability of acceptance or the level of risk alpha or beta to the producer or consumer. So first, if it is given that first alpha and p are given, and then we figure out value of n. So we have n and c values, and with this n and c values we want to figure out beta and p, or the other way around, beta and p could be given, and then we figure out n and c values and then evaluate this plan and figure out the alpha and p. So if there are two parameters everywhere, so we can take guess values of c here and find n values of those according to the value of c here. If the p value is not given, then we can guess some value of p. So for beta we take the value of p as 0.06, for alpha we take the value of p as 0.01 to evaluate the plan. So how can we evaluate the plan is, so we did here, we figured out the n and c value. So let's assume that p value for the AQL. So here the p value will be corresponding to AQL with risk beta, it will be with corresponding to LQL level. So with AQL, let's producer's AQL be required p 0.01. So cumulative till p, that is till AQL, we must have passed the probability of acceptance, that is the required probability. So since it was good lot, that is producer's risk must be least. Since it is good lot, we have acceptable quality level, so it must be accepted. So the value of n, c and p should be such that the probability of acceptance, so we have assumed p, n and c we have evaluated using the previous given values of parameter. So we want to find out the value of pa, and this pa should be maximized. So if we have number of values of n and c, so it could be possible that number of combination of n and c are possible, because if we take 1 then we can get some value of n, if we take 2 we get some another value of n, if we take 3 we get another value of n. So in that case there are n1, c1, n2, c2, there are many combination of n and c possible, which will give the required probability as asked. So in this case what we do is we use this n and c values and figure out the probability, the other side probability. So if alpha was given, we find beta, and initially if beta was given we find alpha, and so what we do is we already know n and p. So we have assumed p value some, we have assumed some p value, we use this n, we find out np, that is the lambda, we go to np and then we find the probability. So that probability should be highest in case of alpha, and probability should be least in case of beta. So here the probability of acceptance should be minimized, and here the probability of acceptance should be maximized. And whichever NC combination are as per our requirement will be the best plan as per the consumer plus producer's point of view. And then we can also use Grubbs table. So what Grubbs table means, that here we use Poisson distribution because the probability, the alpha and beta values were floating. So alpha could have been 0.015, so that is 1.5%, 2%, 0.55%. So Grubbs table have made our life simpler. Here the fixed alpha value has been 5% and beta value is fixed to 10%. So this table has been made, which has alpha value and beta value fixed. So there is acceptance number, very much similar to Poisson distribution. Then we have probability of acceptance with alpha is equal to 5%, that is PA is equal to 0.95, and NP values are given, that is mean values are given. And then PA for beta is equal to 10%, that is PA is equal to 0.10, NP values are given here. So we can directly, so these are the probability of acceptance are 0.95, probability of acceptance are 0.10, and the mean value, NP values are listed here according to C values. So we can directly use this plan. but this can be only used for specific value of alpha and beta. For general value of alpha and beta, we approach with this method. So this makes very simple. So if producer's risk alpha is given as 5%, beta is given as 10%, and at alpha of 5%, the lot are 1.8% non-conforming, and beta at 10%, the lots are 9% non-conforming. That means here the LQL is 1.8%, and at 10%, if beta is 10%, the lot is 9%. So this quality level is 9%. And now we want to figure out this curve, that is the value of N and C. So the first step is to take the ratio of LQL and AQL, that is NP2 divided by NP1, that is P2 by P1, it is 5 over here. And then we use the Grubbs table. So we use the Grubbs table. NP2 and NP1 values are listed. So the ratio, the fourth column here is NP2 divided by NP1. So we find out the correct row which has the value 5, and then we can use this row to check the value of C, to check the value of NP as per our requirement. So here we'll have two values of PA. Two values, both of these two values will give. So P are given already, the bad quality and good quality non-conformance level. So we'll have two values of N, one with respect to alpha and one with respect to beta. And then we can figure out which is the best value. So we'll see how we can figure out. And then if C value is not completely found, so if here we have 5.5 and we have 4.3, then we will not interpolate over here because we cannot interpolate the value of C. Hence we need to take all the plants which are corresponding close to the value of 5. So we took two plants. So there are two values of C which are possible. C is equal to 2, C is equal to 3. So there are four values of N. 2 with respect to alpha, 2 with respect to beta. So there are four plants which we have, which are listed over here. So C is equal to 2. N1 is with respect to PA, is respect to with alpha, and N2 is with respect to beta, the second column and the third column. And with C is equal to 3, we'll have two values of N and P, N1 and N2. So this all will meet the requirement very closely, but then we need to find the best close N and C values which will get the closest to the requirement. So when N1 NP1 column is used, then it will meet the producer's risk requirement. So when we use the values of N from this column, that means that we are completely fulfilling the value of alpha, and beta can be somewhat outside 10%. So it can go to 8%, 9%, 12%, 11%. And when we use the values of N which are from this column, then we are completely fulfilling the requirement of the consumer's risk, but then producer risk can vary. So then there are two possibilities which we have to take. So we are fulfilling whom of them? We are fulfilling the producer, or we are fulfilling the consumer? So if we take the consumer risk is floating and producer risk is fulfilled first, then NP2 we need to use, and it will meet the consumer risk exactly at 10%. So there are two possibilities. So if producer's risk is fixed, then there are the C values as N is C and N combinations are given. And if we fix the consumer's point, then C is equal to 2, N is equal to 60, C is equal to 3, N is equal to 75 is there. And then we can evaluate the plan N and C, which of this is better for consumer, and here we can evaluate this plan, which of this is better for the producer, and whichever is the better will be accepted by both of them, consumer and producer. So how can we evaluate this plan? I have already said earlier, we take the N and C values and some estimate. Here estimate is not required because the non-conformance level are already given. So we can use the value of P, we can use the value of N, and C to find out the probability of acceptance from the Poisson distribution. And then for producer's risk, we want the probability to be maximized. So we take the NC values from here and P value from here, and we find the probability of acceptance. Two probability of acceptance will come, and whichever probability is maximum will be best for the producer. And on the other side, we find the values of NP from here, and we find the probability of acceptance. And for the producer, for the consumer, this probability should be minimum. So hence they will take the plan accordingly. And next time we'll see how can we make the double sampling plans.